These are geotextile, so they can be all different. They're made of yarns, so it's kind of like a fabric. And when they make it, so they can make it in the random orientation, those fabric, or they can do it more or less in the vertical direction. So this one, this is non-woven. It's very soft material, is good for drainage. It doesn't add any strength to the soil or soil structures, but it can work very well as a separation. So it will separate, for example, rock particles from fine particles, and also for filtration. This is another variation of geotextile, but this one what we call woven. So you will see this interlacing between fabrics. Typically it's done at right angles. So that will add additional strength to the material. It can still work really well as a separation and for filtration. Another example of geotextile, this one is also woven. You can see those that are interlacing at a different angle, so of the fabric. So, but this one is actually even stronger than the previous one. It can also work as a good separation material, for example, for large rocks and soil, and it can also provide good drainage. These are geogrids, different examples. The idea of geogrids is to add additional tensile strength to the soil or earth structure that we use these materials for. So this one you will see that it's going to add structure only in this direction. Let's call it vertical direction. So if we stretch it, so that will add additional tensile strength along this direction. This is slightly different. So this one are going to add the strength in both directions, so perpendicular to each other, not only in the vertical direction, but also in this, in the opposite horizontal direction. So still in this vertical direction, it's more reinforced. So maybe there is a special purpose to reinforce it in this direction. So we can use it like this or that. It depends on the practical application. So they're bonded, so the materials are glued together. And this is just another variation of geogrid. Again, you will see that it will provide more strength in this direction where we have these black strips, but they're still glued together so that they add strength in both directions perpendicular to each other. This is another example of geogrid. So this one is a bit different. This is triaxial geogrid, which is kind of similar to this one, which is biaxial geogrid. But in this case, we have improved tensile strength in three different directions, which would make it actually much stronger. And it would improve the properties in three different directions. These are examples of geomembranes. The idea of geomembranes to allow the permeability of water or leachates, or to control the flow of liquids. So this material, it's actually almost not permeable. It has very, very low permeability, even lower than very plastic clay. It can be different. It can be thicker like this one, thicker and denser, or it can be a little bit thinner and kind of a bit rigid. It can have a smooth surface or rough surface. So rough surface will provide better interaction between soil and geomembranes. It will add some friction between these two materials. For this geomembrane, you will see this kind of shiny like little particles. That's very fine sand. So it will also add additional friction. Why do we need friction is that, for example, if we put it on a slope, like at this angle, it can be even steep angle. So in this case, these geomembranes are not going to slide, because of this friction between this surface and the soil. So these are very good to collect leachates, to save nature, to prevent chemicals from going inside the groundwater. These are two examples of geocomposites. Geocomposites is when we combine different materials. So in this case, we have a geonet inside, very thick one, and sandwiched with a geotextile. So geotextile will prevent fine particles from going inside these geonets,
because if fine particles go inside the geonets, it will decrease the drainage capacity of these geocomposites. This one is prefabricated vertical drains, kind of similar idea. Inside we have a geonet that will provide good drainage of water, and around it we have this sort of geotextile material which is very porous, and water can go inside through those pores. So what we use it for when we do consolidation of very plastic and low permeability clay, we insert them vertically in the soil mass, and then water will go inside, and then it will be easily drained in the vertical direction to the surface through these geonets.